let's talk about why dx dy dz is equal to rho squared sine phi d rho d theta dv. And we do this whenever we have a triple integral that requires change of coordinates, going from rectangular to spherical. And it took me a very long time to see how to draw the pictures for you guys to make this clear. So hopefully you guys do find this to be clear and helpful. And I'll show you guys the Jacobian way next time. All right, here we go. Let's say we have a point somewhere here. And in the spherical coordinate system, we will have to know the distance from the origin to the point. So let's say it's right here. And we are going to call that rho. And then we have to do two rotations. The first rotation is we rotate our body. And that's the rotation from the positive x-axis to this. And then the second rotation is we will have to rotate our arms like this. So we can aim the fly over there. And that is the rotation from the positive z-axis to here. And the hard part of this is how to draw the picture to make this clear. Here are my tips for you guys. First, I'm just going to draw some dashed lines. Starting with the origin, I'm just going to put down a dashed line like this. And then for the other dashed line, I'm going to make it wider apart. I find it more clear that way. So you guys can see the difference. So something like this. And the tip is that make sure rho, this right here, is shorter than the other two. Now we are going to connect them by its curves. So right here, my first rotation will be going from here to here with this curve. And then the other rotation, I will connect from here to here, again with curves. Next, I'm going to extend the rho a little bit because that's going to be my d rho. And then you do the same thing right here, and then also right here. Just extend them a little bit. Finally, connect the dots, but with curves though. So here, and then here. And lastly, from here to here. And this right here should be like a small chunk of a sphere. So just like a small part of the pokeball like this. I know you guys haven't seen this for a while, but it's always here. And what's happening is this right here as well. Remember our polar rectangle, right? A curved rectangle like this, right? So on the xy plane, we have this shape. And in the spherical system, it's that you pretty much just rotate it like this, like that. So you can generate that solid. And it's meant to be just a tiny bit. Now, we just have to find the volume of this shape. To do so, we just need to figure out the dimensions, this, this, and that, and multiply them. This volume formula works like a cube, right? Firstly, we know this right here is just d rho. It's just a small extension of the rho. It's a small change in the rho. And this right here is meant to be very small, okay? But if I draw it too small, nobody can see it. Now, this right here, it's not bad to figure out. Because this angle, we call this angle phi, but if you're a physics major, you will call this angle theta. I know, we can never agree on the notation, but we just respect each other. That said, this angle here is just a small change of the angle phi, so it's just d phi. So this right here is just a small arc, right? To find the length, we just need the radius, which is rho, times this angle, which is dv. So this right here is just rho times dv. Now, we need to figure this out, and this is the hardest part. And I will show you guys how to see it better. The trick is, if you just project it down to the xy plane, this right here. And then you are going to connect here to here with an arc. Here. The reason we do that is because once we're on the xy plane, this right here is what? It's just a polar coordinate, right? So you will need to know from here to here, and that's just r. And then if you connect the dots from here all the way to here, this right here is what? It's just a small change of an angle right here, right? D theta. and we want this curve. Once again, the radius times the angle for this little arc is just r d theta. But here's a small issue. Because in the spherical coordinate system, we are not supposed to be using r. But it's okay because I know you guys have seen my video. Last time I showed you guys that the r, it's the same as what? Rho sine phi times d theta afterward. And then we're done. I know, you guys didn't see the video. So don't worry, I'm going to show you guys why r is equal to rho sine phi right here as well. Okay. The way that I figure it's the easiest is do the following. Here is r, and notice earlier we dropped this down, right? This right here is a right angle because it's perpendicular to the xy plane. What I'm going to do is, to draw a 3D picture, I'm just going to draw the parallel dashed line right here. So this is r, that's also going to be r. Now, this is the z-axis, and this r is on the xy plane. So this angle is 90 degrees for sure. This is 90, that's 90, and they are parallel. Well, of course, this right here will also be 90 degrees. And that will be 90 degrees, but we don't want that. What we want is this right triangle. Because we have the angle phi, and then this right here is just the hypotenuse. And this right here is just the opposite. So how do we find the opposite? Use sine, right? Sine phi equals opposite over hypotenuse, and then multiply the hypotenuse on both sides. So it's just rho times sine of that angle phi, and that is r, and that's why I told you guys earlier. And this is this arc, rho sine phi d theta. Now, ladies and gentlemen, d phi is just the following of this thing, and this thing behaves like a little cube. You just need to multiply this and that to get a little volume for this. I will put down this right here first, which is rho d phi, and then next I have this, which is rho sine phi, and then d theta, and lastly I will put this down, which is d rho. And of course we can simplify this a little bit. Rho times rho, here is the rho squared, and then here is the sine phi, and then lastly we will just put down this in order, d rho, d theta, and d phi. Hopefully this right here is clear. That's it.